In this video, we will present our findings of Cherry Tree Cricket Club's roles within the community. We will give a detailed overview of the club's current and past standings and their aims for the future. We will cover all areas, including history, finance, facilities, coaches, and volunteers. Like the
legend of the Phoenix. Cherry Tree Cricket Club has progressed well over the past few decades. With an increase in stature due to playing facilities, Cherry Tree is now a top club in Blackburn and has financial links with Thwaites and local businesses.
How has the club progressed and evolved over the past few years?
Progressed. Basically, facilities have been improved inside and outside.
She's up all night to the sun. I'm up all night to get some. Club has worked hard to improve their facilities over the years. They have ownership of their ground and clubhouse, which includes changing rooms, bar, social areas and outdoor training facilities.
In winter, the club trains at a local high school and makes use of their indoor facilities.
Throughout the winter, with St Wilfrid's facility, which we have here, to keep on top of the cricket throughout the winter time. The present has no ribbon.
Your gift keeps on giving. How do you cover the cost of all your facilities? Obviously that's quite a big...
Yeah, it is. The boys. Anything else. It's, you know, that is the, you've got the bar which brings regular income, especially during the summer, much more income at that time. But also you've got sponsorship deals with lots of different sponsors. You've got Thwaites who provide the beer, but obviously they do that because we're making a profit on employees. But they provide sponsorship over that. We've got a 3-year deal with them. So long as we stick with them, sell their beers, they provide us with £3,000 a year. We also have a club sponsor who, you know, has another deal where he sponsors the shirt, his name on the shirt, name's on the end of the building. So again, he, you know, that brings money in. And the club will always be open to sponsorship deals. Can't see it in the dark, but that bottom fence is full of sponsorship boards. So, you know, so different sponsors for the club pay £85 a year to have the name on there. And again, that's another, you know, revenue earned. And the other one is that we have people who sponsor boards. And again, you'll have through, you know, you talked about we had 48 new boards last season, and then 42 this season. But that is a substantial cost in terms of a cricket ball is like, you know, sort of thick end of a tenner a time. So, you know, it's, So that's, you know, that's where the, you know, where we look to, and, you know, sort of the subscription as well, you know, social subscriptions, player subscriptions, and local kids as well, like Sam.
How do you go about finding funding?
Depends what we're after, really. There's various sporting bodies. There's Sport England that look towards facilities. There's probably a list of about 30 different governing bodies who give you funding, providing you apply to the right ones for the right thing, really. So there's, for example, there's one at the minute, sports match, the match, whatever your sponsor will give you, as a means for you to say £3,000 for a sponsor for a year, the club will give you another £3,000, and then you just spend it on the club facilities and get it receipted and stuff like that. But yeah, you get a lot of help from Lancashire Cricket Board, in particular Paul Bryson, who's a lead for our area, and he just tells you. You tell him what shortcomings are as a club, and he'll tell you where to go, really. And it's up to you to do the legwork and all your applying and stuff.
I mean, in rants, or, you know, three pots of money that you could access.
Yeah, there are. That's what, again, when we talk about this inspired facilities. He's a provider of grants who we've been to before. We are hopefully going to get an application into them. We need a new boiler. We need various things. We need the drive sorting out. Parish Council provide a grant. We always go to them. Offers about £1,500, and there's also this Biffa thing where we're looking to them to help us with the new training facility. So yeah, there are, you know, any number of different trainers that we know to.
Do you rely on these then to carry the club on?
Well, no, they do. I mean, the grants. Yeah, that doesn't keep the club running. It provides it with the facilities to keep the fabric together. Yeah, you keep this building together. You know, the training facility is something that's important. If you've got a decent training facility, hopefully, you get a better class of player coming along, and you can also, you know, sort of coach and train a better class of player if you've got the right facilities. So, it's not relying on them just to run that.
The club covers its costs through several mediums, such as subscription fees, bar takings, and sponsorship deals. As it is a club which aims to progress all the time, they find themselves eligible to apply for several funding schemes through leading bodies, such as Sport England and Inspired Facilities. I can beat the night. I'm not afraid of the
Cherry Tree currently has 11 qualified coaches with a range of different experience and knowledge, with 6 level 1s, 4 level 2s and 1 level 3, coaching at all levels within the club.
Through our investigations, we have seen how all the coaches communicate and work together to help provide the best quality of coaching to all participants. An amiable quality of the club, so anyone who is eager to get involved in helping the teams out and wants to coach will be helped through their qualifications, both financially and supportively.
Basically, how many coaches work within the club? In the seniors, we have a couple of coaches that do work with senior veterans, mainly Dr. Mark Butler, who's a top level coach who works with ECB. With juniors, we have about up to a dozen coaches who come down Thursday night, some being younger members of our club, some parents and senior members in the club. They're not selected as much as their people that actually want to give up their time for us, and we're lucky that we have people that want to do that. We're not blessed by the ability of coaching, but we're ones we have really good coaches.
Volunteers are required in all clubs. It became clear that at Cherry Tree they have many volunteers covering many roles, such as chairman, secretary, coaches, amongst others.
From an age, early age of 5 up to 90. You've got social members, you've got playing members.
Oh, okay.
Social membership's £15.
Quite cheap.
Yeah. Playing members, I mean, that may just go up. It's £7, it's going up £7 a game.
Alright.
I'll be paying £25, £30 up front.
So the social members, do they just come here to use the facilities, or do they
offer anything
else to the club?
Or watch the match.
That's it?
Yeah, no. Social members, there's new kit.
Yeah.
They use that. Use the bar, watch the match, which they don't get charged for watching the match. Only the people who come, the supporters from the other team, they come and watch. They have to pay £2 usually. We don't charge anymore.
Right.
So £15 a year, that's it. So it's quite cheap. Either.
Yes.
Club's members are built up of both playing and social members. They pay a yearly subscription fee, and with that, they are granted access to use all of the club's facilities and bar. Clubmark is a prestigious award for local clubs in the community. It shows that the operational status is successful and fully functional, as well as providing members with the welfare benefits they need to enjoy the sport.
We're a Clubmark club, which other people know more about than me. Mark knows a lot about. That's all to do with accreditation within the LCB, which obviously then moves up to the ECB. You get accreditation on that every 3 years, and then that allows you to do things like being a focus club, and allows you routes into funding facilities. For that, you have to sort of like keep the folder that we have somewhere. It's basically coaches.
Yeah. Effectively, club mark is a kite mark. Yeah. Okay. So it's to do with quality assurance. So as you would with lots of institutions these days, schools being one, for example, if you can demonstrate that your institution, your organisation, effectively operates to the standards that, in our case, parents would expect us to operate, then clearly from a marketing point of view, from an attracting point of view, it's a positive thing. Yeah. So club mark essentially focuses on the governance of the club, so that obviously relates to the committee, but then it focuses heavily on the junior section. So such things as, for example, have you got sufficient coaches? What's the coach to player ratio? How many teams do you run? What competitions do you enter? So that tends to focus heavily on the junior section. Coaching qualifications, CRBs, first area, that type of thing. What's the structure that you've got in place to look after these kids? And then beyond that, club mark also focuses on the club itself. So it focuses on the quality of its facility. Does the club, for example, have side screens? Does it have covers? You know. So club mark is, if you like, is an estimate. It's an analysis of a cricket club to see if it satisfies basic standards. Which, coming back to the question you asked before about the ECB, something that the ECB governs.
Club mark also implements a desire to continue in sport during later life for young members, and provides them with a coaching pathway. Ultimately, the club requires to maintain club mark to progress and grow. Club's players and members are all residents of the local area, so this alone shows that the club is important in the community and is a place for locals to enjoy sport and socialise, therefore bringing people together.
It's got a massive impact on local children. It provides a cricketing facility throughout the summer. We run under 9s, under 11s, under 13s, under 15s, under 17 and 18 cricket. We have practice throughout the summer on a Thursday night with qualified coaches, not only for cricketers who've got a fair amount of ability, but for also for those lads who are starting out in the cricket team, the qualified coaches providing some top class.
The club is inclusive and offers anyone with interest an opportunity to be a part of the club and enjoy themselves.
What do you see the club's sort of role within the community? So, what does it offer the local community?
I mean, it's a hub for the community. It's a great place, particularly in the summer, for people to come down, whether it's to have a drink or play a bit of sport, go and spend some time with family. So it's a really good, friendly family atmosphere. I bring my daughter down to watch Jimmy League games. It's a great, family environment.
So you see there's a lot of club togetherness?
There is. I mean, in the past there's been issues with the club, but I think last year, through the difficult times of the club, financially and other issues with player numbers, we've really come together and really pushed on. We had a bad season playing-wise, but as a club it's been the best it's been in my 10 years.
The club's members and the club's players reflect sort of like the local area around here. Yeah.
We do have a few Asians come from out of the area because the cricket ground has closed down.
So you're offering them a service? On night to get some, she's
up on night for good fun. The club does not have much of a variation in ethnicities, so could be deemed as not being representative of Blackburn. However, the local area is predominantly white English, so the club does represent the local area.
Why is there not a girls' cricket team?
Because we haven't got enough girls taking part in training nights. I think we've only got two in the clash.
So basically not enough participants. Yeah.
There is no disability team, as there isn't the right qualified people at the club to work with the team and provide the best service they deserve. The club also claims there has been very little interest externally in starting a disability team.
To introduce disability cricket?
If we had pupils come for the disability, then we would find an area where we could make them welcome and take part, if that's...
Do you think there's any reasons why girls and people with disabilities don't participate more?
Maybe it's not advertised. Yeah. Maybe girls don't see it as a sport, or girls, maybe, because it's not many, it's not advertised on TV, is it? You see, it's always male cricketers, and maybe that's the reason.
The club doesn't run a girls team, but is open to starting one. Currently and previously, there have been a few girls participate in cricket at a young age, but often drop off due to the largely male-dominated sport.
Alright, yeah, that's it, I think.
Is that it?
Good,
yeah. Okay, yeah. Pleasure's been all yours.